United Nations Watch, please.
Thank you, Mr. President. As the High Commission said, the old order in the Middle East is slowly vanishing, but the transition is still uncertain. How can the international human rights movement play a helpful role? To begin, we must not appease prejudice. The president of Egypt only 3 years ago told Egyptians to, quote, nurse our children and grandchildren on hatred for Jews and Zionists. We must make it clear to human rights activists that we expect them to be different. On March 8th, U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry and First Lady Michelle Obama presented Women of Courage awards to several bloggers and human rights protesters. Egyptian activist Samira Ibrahim was supposed to be among them, but it was discovered that she celebrated terrorism against Israelis and on the anniversary of 9/11 said America should burn. At the last minute, she was removed from the ceremony. Similarly, in Geneva, the jury of prestigious Martin and Nall's Human Rights Award, comprised of 9 NGOs, announced that an Egyptian blogger, Mona Saif, was one of their 3 final nominees for 2013. 2 Egyptian human rights activists, Ami Bakli and Mikhail Nabil, protested that Saif supported terrorism. Indeed, Saif has encouraged the sacking of the Israeli embassy and repeatedly advocated blowing up the Sinai gas pipeline. Even worse, in November, when Amnesty International and Human Rights Watch issued calls for Hamas to stop firing rockets against Israeli citizens, Saif vehemently objected, saying the attacks were justified as resistance. Without peace, there is little hope for human rights, said Martin Inals, the first Secretary General of Amnesty. We agree. Someone who advocates violence against peace should never be celebrated as a model human rights activist. At stake is their future and ours. Thank you, Mr. President.